guess this works too. Jeremy? What the hell is that? There was a dead body in here. Did I just imagine that? Another one of those plates from the talisman. It's also broken and missing some pieces. I need the key.
Do you teach piano as well?
Huh?
You're a governess. Did you teach those clawing Casino kids how to play the piano?
How do you know about that?
Just because grown-ups don't notice children, doesn't mean we don't notice you.
Yes. I taught them some piano.
Are you any good at it?
Not good enough to play a broken one.
It fell from the attic. Brought half the ceiling down.
It was Jeremy's fault, wasn't it?
Nobody knows what happened. But you're not wrong. I'm gonna go now. See you around.
The prick of the syringe hadn't hurt as much as the humiliation of being played by that child. Emily just couldn't make any sense of her behavior. Grace seemed amused, but not mocking. Was this just her being playful? As her feelings subsided, a second thought appeared. She wouldn't have injected her with something, would she?
Ugh. There's more of that unsettling rot.
On the commonplace of evil.
I can't leave. I need to find Jeremy. that stain? Looks like some kind of rot.
Come on, Grace. I'm too tired for games. I'll even let you play with my jackknife. Oh, good evening. You haven't seen a little girl by any chance, have you?
I don't think so.
You would have known if you did. The only kid crazy enough to be in this place.
She's not in her room, then?
That would be a first. Always running around causing trouble. She's very hard to pin down, that one. You want to sip?
I'm good, thank you.
Well, I should be going then. Unless there's anything you need from me.
I just want to find my uncle before anything happens to him.
Oh, don't worry, miss. He'll show up. He is much too lily-livered to kill himself.
Why would he?
It's his greatest ambition, didn't you know? Take care now.
McCarthy moseyed off to continue his search for the little girl. Emily had meant to ask why he was looking for her.
There's something missing. So this is Grace's room. Cute.
Don't you worry, Grace.
Terrible thing to recognize that your betterment was an illusion. That you are so infatuated by the virtue of struggling that despite all your hard work, you made no... What did you expect from them? You created too much. There wasn't any room to breathe. Your reification rendered all possible worlds void. You took everything they could imagine and constrained it into something that you didn't even care about. Or maybe you did. Perhaps you cared the most of all. Maybe you tried to save them from themselves, and that is why you had to die. As the world moved into the new decade, America was spiraling into a maelstrom of debt, drought, and death. It was called... There are many ways to cross a threshold. The easiest one is being invited.
This must be the great Cassandra Beauregard's room. I'm not sure what I expected. Maybe something more extravagant? What's that? I'm not sure I have everything I need. I need something else.
Miss Beauregard, I picked up your medicine at the post office today. As you understand, it needs to be administered by the orderlies for your safety.
I think I've seen this somewhere. I need the key. talisman is showing another wound. Something is opened. It worked. I'm in another one of Jeremy's dreams. It's been a while since I visited the family tomb. I hope it's in a better state than the real world. This. What's that for? There we go. Yeah. we go. I made it out.
Thank you. Emily, is that you?
Jeremy.
What are you doing here?
Well, you sounded so miserable in your letter. I've come to take you away from here.
I can't believe I made such a foolish mistake. All I wanted was for you to stay away.
What do you mean?
I bargained with the Dark Man. A pact to keep Nolan safe with my own life as tribute.
The Dark Man isn't real, Jeremy. There is nothing he can do to hurt you.
How do you think any of this is happening? How do you still not trust my words?
Fine. Then let me help.
Don't be foolish. He will bury you next to me in his sunken temple for an eternity.
I don't care. I'll find a way. I have my own talisman, and I know about Tarawea.
Oh, wait. Don't speak.
Who's in here? Show yourself.
You know who, Emily. He took your grandfather.
No, I mean it. Who's in here? I can feel someone's in here.
Emily!
Tarawea. Why do you want to go there, Jeremy?
I've seen so many strange occurrences lately. Memories explode into existence and then burn out.
I need to find out more about Jeremy's pact with the Dark Man. He meant to go to Tarawea. Maybe there is something there that would help. She was beautiful. I wonder what happened to her.
Ferus's fate remained a mystery to Emily. Was she a part of Jeremy's story? Or did she maybe have her own? Despite suffering the Heartwood curse herself, Emily never thought she would be seeing the Dark Man manifested in front of her eyes. To it was the Emily, the
What did you expect from them? You created. As the world.
Telescope lens. Well, why would he lock it in here? What's going on? It's entering the numbers by itself? Okay, great, so where is that? Here we go.
You should not have come, Emily.
How do you know my name? Have we met?
In a manner of speaking. As a manifestation of Yermi's deepest desires, I am to you unfamiliar. Yet I know of you.
Are you Jeremy? Is that what you're saying?
I am only his subconscious thoughts. I cannot speak for his totality.
How come you have a Spanish accent? And what is this place? Is this Tarawea?
This is indeed the fabled convent of Tarawea, where Yermi goes to find peace during his sessions with Dr. Gray.
It's all fantasy then?
Based on the things he has read and seen.
And that includes you?
Yes. My name is Juan Luis Jorge. Yermi once read a book of mine. It stuck with him.
Can you help me break the pact with the Dark Man so we can leave Dorseto?
Yermi doesn't want you to. He wants to honor his word to the Dark Man.
Why? What's the point? I don't understand what the pact is for.
The people of Dorseto are calling upon evil to enter this world. Your uncle offered his soul to the Dark Man to contain this disaster.
What? No, that doesn't make any sense.
The pact will be fulfilled at dawn. As the sun rises, Yermi will forever be entombed in his sunken desert temple. As promised. The Dark Man shall quarantine and starve the evil inside their Seto.
What about all the patients and the staff?
They will not stand the chance.
That's unacceptable. How could Yermi agree to this?
Desperation, of course. Yermi did not choose martyrdom lightly.
Well, nothing is lost yet. I'm sure I can find a way to break the pact and save Yermi, and hopefully the people at Dorseto. What even is this evil you're talking about?
I don't know much. I think some nightmarish entity from the bayou.
I'll just have to deal with that later. First, I have to get Jeremy out of his deal. What? Did you run out of arguments?
You're actually quite inspiring, Miss Emily. If we put Jeremy's feelings aside, I would have to say I agree with you.
Really?
You might just be able to save the old man from himself. I think you should take a look in the convent library. Try to find the truth about Yermi's relationship with the Dark Man.
Okay.
You should know that you won't be alone in those grand halls. The Dark Man has been reading those books for years.
He's here?
You'll have to be very careful.
Of course. I can be careful.
Good luck, Miss Emily.
Ugh.
What's this?
Bull worship is common throughout history. For Christians, this can be seen in Exodus when the Israelites turn to worship a golden calf in Moses' absence. This passage shows the people falling back to the worship witnessed in Egypt, known as the Hapis Bull. Another famous example is the Minoans on the island of Crete. Their worship of the bull gave rise to the myth of the Minotaurus, the half-man, half-bull monster that reigned the labyrinth. But for this particular case, I think I should tell you about the deity Astarte that brought the Taurus constellation to life to attack Gilgamesh. Even for a mythical hero, this celestial bull would prove difficult to defeat. Only by distracting the bull with a golden sail was Gilgamesh able to pierce an eye with the spear, which bled the bull to death.
Yeah. It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution.
Emily!
I hope you found what you were looking for, Emily. I fear there is no going back.
He's in my head, Juan. His breath replacing mine.
You should not have come, Emily.
Friend, come, join me for some giggle water.
Ruth?
Oh, Miss Hotwood, don't tell me you've been out swinging without me.
Ruth, what is this place? Where are we?
Have you never been to the Maccabean before? Goodness me. Tell me, Miss Hotwood. Have you ever considered going out for an evening?
Are we in New Orleans?
Oh, who can tell anymore? I just went inside the Grand Parlor and suddenly here I am.
The Grand Parlor? Can I get back to Dorsetto from here?
Are you sure you want to? We could stay here and drink the night away. How about a gin fizz?
If this is New Orleans, maybe I should go further. Find that magic show the book was talking about. But there was no address, just Prague's Shipping Company.
Oh, is this about where Jeremy met the dock man?
How do you know about that?
Jeremy talked a lot about the dock man. I always felt a bit envious.
How so?
If an all-powerful entity showed me any interest, I'd at least hear him out. I'm sure he has plenty to offer.
I don't think you'd want that, Ruth. You're too sweet for such darkness.
Oh, please. What kind of blue nose do you take me for? I relish the darkness. I think it suits me.
You don't happen to know how to find the Prague Shipping Company, do you?
Of course. Their office is just over there.
Whoa, what happened?
You just got lucky. A bientôt, Mademoiselle Emily.
Hey, do you know where my uncle is?
No, but I bet you're close.
New Orleans lies southwest of Dorsetto, along the great Mississippi River. Its old town, the French Quarter, or the Vieux Carré, is home of the proud and often rich Creoles. Wrapped around this center, you will find a large and eclectic city full of people, including the most mundane dock workers, reckless gangsters, jazz-crazed flappers, and of course, the mysterious voodoo people. At night, you can stand on the lakeside of Dorsetto and watch New Orleans glow like embers on the horizon.
It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds to witness the enigmatic Black Pharaoh. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear wherever he performed. It was the sort of thrills my father sought out, especially if there was a promise of electrical trickery. The Nolan's address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution in the morning papers. There were rumors of an Egyptian sarcophagus being a part of the act, something which kept me wondering how they had carried that up the seemingly endless stairs.
Prague's Shipping Company. According to the book in the Great Library, they assisted a showman performing somewhere in New Orleans. It's somehow connected to Jeremy's introduction to the Dark Man. I'm sure I can find the address inside.